and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss differential coefficient of x raised to power n and ax plus b whole raised to power n, where x is greater than 0 and x belonging to R, that is the set of real numbers, n is an integer or a rational number. First, let y be equal to x raised to power n. Mark this equation as 1. Let delta x be increment in x. And delta y be corresponding increment in y. That y plus delta y is equal to x plus delta x whole raised to power n. Mark this equation as 2. Subtract equation 1 from equation 2. We get delta y is equal to x plus delta x whole raised to power n minus x raised to power n, or delta y can be written as x raised to power n into 1 plus delta x by x whole raised to power n minus x raised to power n. Here delta x is small, therefore delta x by x may be considered less than 1 numerically. Therefore, applying binomial theorem, for any index we get delta y is equal to x raised to power n into 1 plus n into delta x by x plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 whole multiplied by delta x by x the whole square plus terms containing higher power of delta x. Minus 1. Therefore we have delta y is equal to x raised to power n into, taking delta x common, we have delta x into n upon x plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 whole multiplied by delta x by x square plus terms containing delta x whole square and higher powers of delta x. Now dividing both the sides by delta x, delta y by delta x is equal to x raised to power n into n upon x plus n into n minus 1 by 1 into 2 whole multiplied by delta x by x square plus terms containing delta x square and higher powers of delta x. Now taking limits as delta x tends to 0, we have limit delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0 is equal to limit x raised to power n into n by x plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 into delta x by x square plus terms containing delta x square and higher powers of delta x as delta x tends to 0. Therefore we have limit delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0 can be written as dy by dx is equal to, now putting the value of delta x as 0 in the right hand side of the equation, we get x raised to power n into n upon x plus 0, which implies that dy by dx is equal to n into x raised to power n minus 1. Therefore we have d by dx of y, that is x raised to power n, is given by n into x raised to power n minus 1, where x belongs to the set of real numbers R and x is greater than 0 and n is an integer or a rational number. For example, we have d by dx of x raised to power 8, which can be written as 8 into x raised to power 8 minus 1, that is 8 into x raised to power 7, and the value of d by dx of x raised to power 5 by 2 is equal to 5 by 2 into x raised to the power 5 by 2 minus 1, that is equal to 5 by 2 into x raised to power 3 by 2. Now again let y be equal to a into x plus b per raised to power n and mark this equation as 1. Let delta x be the increment in x and delta y the corresponding increment in y. So that y plus delta y is equal to a into x plus delta x plus b whole raised to power n and mark this equation as 2, subtracting equation 1 from equation 2 we have delta y is equal to a into x plus delta x plus b whole raised to power n minus of a into x plus b whole raised to power n. Delta y is equal to a into x plus a into delta x plus b whole raised to power n minus of a into x plus b whole raised to power n. We can also write delta y as ax plus b plus a delta x whole raised to power n minus ax plus b whole raised to power n. Or we can write it as delta y is equal to, now taking a into x plus b whole raised to power m common from both the terms, we get a into x plus b whole raised to power m into 1 plus a into delta x upon a into x plus b whole raised to power m minus 1, that is delta y is equal to a into x plus b whole raised to power m into 1 plus a into delta x upon a into x plus b whole raised to power m can be written using binomial theorem as 1 plus m into a into delta x upon a into x plus b plus m into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 into a delta x upon a into x plus b whole raised to the power 2 plus terms containing higher powers of delta x minus 1. Now delta y is equal to a into x plus b whole raised to the power n into n into a into delta x upon a into x plus b plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 multiplied by a into delta x upon a x plus b the whole square plus terms containing higher powers of delta x . Now delta y is equal to a into x plus b whole raised to power n, and taking delta x common from all the terms, we have delta x into n into a upon a into x plus b plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 multiplied by a square into delta x upon a into x plus b the whole square plus terms containing higher powers of delta x . Now dividing both the sides by delta x . We get delta y by delta x is equal to a into x plus b whole raised to power m into n into a upon a into x plus b plus n into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 into a square into delta x upon a into x plus b the whole square plus terms containing higher powers of delta x taking limits as delta x tends to 0 limit delta y by delta x as delta x tends to 0 is equal to limit a into x plus b whole raised to power m into m into a upon a into x plus b plus m into n minus 1 upon 1 into 2 into a square into delta x upon a into x plus b the whole square plus terms containing higher powers of delta x as delta x tends to 0. Now, limit delta y upon delta x as delta x tends to 0 can be written as dy by dx and is equal to, now putting the value of delta x as 0 in the right hand side of the equation, we get ax plus b whole raised to power n into n into a upon a into x plus b plus 0. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to a into x plus b whole raised to power n into a upon a into x plus b, which can be written as dy by dx is equal to n into a into x plus b whole raised to power n minus 1. Therefore, we have d by dx of y, that is a into x plus b whole raised to power n, is equal to n into a into x plus b whole raised to power n minus 1. And we can also write it as n into a into x plus b whole raised to power n minus 1 into a. That is, if we have d by dx of a linear function of x raised to power n, then it's equal to n into linear function raised to power n minus 1 into coefficient of x. For example, if we have d by dx of 3x plus 5 whole raised to power 7, then this is equal to 7 into 3x plus 5 whole raised to power 7 minus 1 into coefficient of x, that is 3. Therefore, we have 7 into 3, that is 21, into 3x plus 5 raised to the power 6. Hence, the value of d by dx of 3x plus 5 whole raised to the power 7 is equal to 21 into 3x plus 5 whole raised to the power 6. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.